safety at sea is very important. And by adding a radar to the Simrad NSX, it now allows you to see land masses, track targets at sea, watch storm fronts. So this will give you that extra peace of mind while you're on the water. So we're gonna walk you through how to set it up and how to view and manage that data. Leave trails on. Once it's ranged and disappears, it's gone. So next is guard zone. So guard zone allows us to set up an area around the vessel, any a certain type of shape or direction where we can look for targets. So I simply go into a guard zone and I have the ability to turn it on or off. And you'll notice this blue area is my guard zone. So you do have the ability by just hitting start range. You'll notice we've got some icons that we can simply click and drag, and we can set that guard zone up to whatever area we want. Now, once we've got it set up, we also have the ability to say how we want to set up the alarm. Do we want it for just targets entering that guard zone, exiting that guard zone, or either or, which is the both, we can set that up as well. So now if we're on a night watch on anchor, if something comes through there, we know to get up, pay attention, look, see if it's somebody that might not know that you're there or somebody you're looking for. And that alarm will simply come up anytime you want. So that's your guard zones. And simply toggle them on and off. The next one as we move down is gonna be your EBL and VRM, that's electronic bearing line and variable range marker. Again, you can go in, we can turn them on, and this just allows you to move this out any place, any position, find a target, and basically get its range and distance. So real quick, real easy, and EBL just allows that, leave it active and move it around. And again, you have two of those and simply toggle it on and off. So as we continue through, we get into some of the advanced features. So noise rejection, again, if you've got some erroneous noise that's showing up that gain, sea, and rain doesn't filter out, you now have a noise rejection setting where you can slowly bring that up till we clean those targets up or clean up that picture. Remember, don't always go to the max because you're gonna start losing targets. So in here, we're gonna say what is our threshold for our targets. So again, this is kind of like a filter. So we don't wanna see anything under a light target return or an erroneous return. We can set that up and make it less aggressive or more aggressive to show targets. But out of the box, it is preset at 30. It is a great starting point until you become a better user of the radar. Leave that at 30 and then slowly start using it and manipulating that data. Target expansion, all that does is takes a small target and makes it bigger. So think of it just a blow up feature, just makes that target bigger. So when we're looking for smaller targets, sometimes turning this on makes it easier to see those smaller targets. Interference rejection, this is for other radars in the area. Now we did go through that and set that up when we set up the radar. But here's where you also have that control after the setup. So again, we got somebody coming next to us who also has a halo radar like we have, and they're transmitting and we're getting these erroneous targets or these streaks of lines across our radar. We can go and slowly increase that interference rejection to clean up that erroneous error. Target separation, again, gives us a contextual information is when we want to separate targets that are close together. So we have the ability to increase the separation, but we gotta remember, as we increase target separation, we are decreasing range of the radar. Not by 20, 30 miles, but we slowly have, because we're focusing on those targets closer to the vessel and we wanna be able to separate them, we do slowly decrease that range for seeing those small targets. And then fast scan allows us to manually set the sweep of the radar. So low or off, we can increase it to a medium or a high. So off just means it's traditional 24 RPM, and then we slow start working it up to 36 and 48. And again, target boost is another one that we kind of talked about earlier, where it's expanding the target, making it larger, making you able to see those smaller targets a lot easier. And again, it's either a low or a high. And that's the menu and how you would drive your radar. So now we continue on as vessels and targets. So now do we want to show our AIS targets? Do we want to show our ARPA targets. So as we're tracking, manually tracking targets, do we want to show that? So here's where we can clear all lost targets if we have some targets that show up, stop tracking all targets. So when we've gone in and adjusted them, and then we go into adjust target filters, this will take us directly into our menu where we can actually set up our TCPA, CPA. So time for closest point of approach, when those alarms are going to go off. If we want to automatically eliminate targets in a certain area, so I don't want anything past 2 miles because to me they're not dangerous targets, I'm not going to worry about it. So this is going and setting up, you know, our filtering. So how many, you know, do we want to show a max number of targets? Do we want to show a max number of AIS? If they're running slower than or lost, at what time do we pull them off the screen? So that will take you right into that menu. And to get back, you simply hit your radar icon and you're back. So again, we're going to hit the screen, pull up our menu. So next we'll go into our guard zones. So guard zones allows us to set up an area where we can set around the vessel, set at any distance or any configuration where we can set it up to give us an alarm. So I simply turn on my guard zone. You'll notice we've already started to set one up here, but you can go in and turn on that alarm, whether it's when a target enters the zone or exits it, or if either or, for both configurations, you can do that. So if we want to go and adjust that, we can simply tap that and you'll notice we get our arrows. So the easiest way is to grab those arrows and manipulate that zone.